Let's go back to Utah and check out some footage of amazing bulls. Throughout the spring, summer, and fall, friends of mine and guides I will work with are out scouting and filming elk. For me, the biggest joy in hunting is the preseason scouting, becoming acquainted with the biggest, oldest, wisest bulls in the state of Utah. A challenge that I find particularly interesting is to find the one bull that will score higher than any other in the state. We here at MossBack find a great deal of pleasure in sharing this kind of rare footage with you. So come along with us as we start the year off scouting, trying to find the one bull, the granddaddy of them all. Most of us here at MossBack would probably scout this way through the summer even without reason, just for the fun of it. But we do have a reason. Here's one more hunt to show you, a hunt for the biggest bull in Utah. Ron Skoronski purchased the Governor's Conservation Tag in 2003. This tag annually brings thousands upon thousands of dollars when sold at auction, which money goes straight to the Wildlife Fund for Elk, protecting and creating habitat and directly benefiting elk and sportsmen alike. This tag is legal anywhere in the state and has an extended season running from September through the end of the year. Because of these two facts, the sportsman who purchased the tag has an opportunity to hunt monster bulls that is unequaled. Ron's goal was to take a bull scoring 400 to 410 Boone and Crockett inches. He would hunt with a bow, with himself or another guide carrying his rifle as backup. We'll be right back. We had several close calls in September, working in and calling bulls up close. Many awesome bulls were watched and evaluated, but we kept hunting. We knew if we didn't find and connect with the biggest bull in the country during the rut, the late fall snows and shorter days would force the bulls out into the open to feed and build reserves for the coming winter. Earlier snows began, and once again we were hitting the mountain slopes and glassing for big bulls. Our hope was to locate a bull that was truly the monster of all monsters, a bull nicknamed Mo.
Today I was up here, I was looking for the big bull. Nicknamed Mo. I asked Clint today why he named the bull Mo. He said it's because it's more bigger than any other bull he's ever seen. Actually, I think we're going to go back and look, but I think this is a shed off Mo. We found him today, just hiking up there to look across the canyon at him. So just an outstanding royal, and that was one of his biggest characteristics, was that big old royal point. So we're going to go check it out, but this is another year. This would be probably the fourth antler off this same site that's been found off this bull. So
here is Clint and his son with some of the years of this great bull, and we appreciate their support. Search as we would, we could find no sign of Mo. We came to believe that he must have depleted his reserves during the 2002 rutting season and died during the late winter, or was killed by a mountain lion attack. Mo was truly a one-of-a-kind bull, and we will miss him. Here's a look at the last footage we got of this awesome bull. Autumn became late fall and winter was threatening. We found several other monster bulls working the high wind swept ridges and hidden sunny spots, feeding throughout the day to replenish their fat reserves against the coming winter. To me, it's not the skill of taking a bull late in the winter months. The skill lies in looking over thousands of bulls for 5 months and knowing which bull will score the highest. Thus, in return, it will help the great conservation program. One evening while I was videoing, I captured a scene on camera that is truly one in a million. As the almost full moon was rising, I filmed a giant bull feeding on a knife edge ridge with the moon behind him. There was no computer graphics or imaging on this footage. It was exactly as you see it. The bull was so close to me that the moon in the telephoto lens was enormous. Watch closely and you will see a jet skim across the moon, so high above the surface of the earth that although dark has fallen, the jet is highlighted by the sun. When we found this bull, we knew that it was time to make a move. He was high and wide with enormous long beams and multiple extra points. We watched and studied him through the spotting scope until there was no doubt. He was the one. In fact, we had videoed this bull in previous years. After studying where the bull was wintering, I called the Fish and Game to assess the boundaries between private properties and the Forest Service. With the blessings of the Fish and Games, we were able to hunt the bull right where he was. It's better to ask for permission rather than suffer the consequences. As we closed in, Ron was prepared to take the giant bull with his bow. The stalk was going well, the bull totally unaware of our presence, when suddenly a deer bursted out of the brush ahead with a coyote in hot pursuit. The coyote actually pulled the deer down and killed it right before our eyes, spooking the monster bull away and up the ridge. Ron trades in his bow for the rifle and prepares to take the shot as the bull threads his way through the thick brush on the ridge.
What do you think?
That is a giant bull.
Stud. Oh my Woo! Gosh. Look at that.
Look at this bull.
Can you believe that?
Woo! He's a long time coming, wasn't he?
Oh
Almost
my.
Almost eight. What's he got? One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, and eight there. What does he got over there, Greg?
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight.
Nine. Counting his beam.
Counting his beam.
Look at Almost this. A 9x8.
Look at this beam on that side.
September 1st to December 16th.
Great mass measurement.
Wow. Webs. Look at that.
Awesome bull.
He's what a beautiful Utah bull.
He's got to be 48, almost 4 foot inside.
What a
and
gorgeous bull. Thanks, Doyle.
Right, congratulations.
Greg, what a beautiful bull.
Greg, buddy.
Woo! What a great bull.
Bull of a lifetime right here.
Nice Christmas present, huh?
I should say so. It was worth holding out. We passed up some giants in September.
Ron thought we were nuts.
Ron definitely thought we were crazy. And
for sure.
I bet that beam's close to 60. We're going to have to tape it off, but it is one exceptional pig. We had a lot of great help. The Mowers, Derek and Cheris, and Kaylin, and Kenny Parcell. Can't thank everybody enough for Art Johnson, who watched this bull a lot for us while he was off hunting elsewhere. But just a lot of...
Had a lot of good help.
A lot of help.
A lot of people involved in getting this bull on the ground.
We looked at a lot of bulls.
Oh boy.
50.
Oh, oh
60.
My.
62 and 4/8.
4/8.
Oh my God.
This bull has got to be close to the big four, if not better.
Magic effort right there.
What did we come up with, Ron?
It's hard to even get it to roll off your lips. 4/14 and 6/8 gross score.
Unbelievable bull. This bull has 17 inch fronts, 13 inch thirds, 21 inch royal hair, 20 over there, 15 and 14. What's his beams, Greg?
62, almost 63, 62 and 7/8 on this
right side.
He is just everything we'd hoped he'd be, and actually a little more. He grew when he hit the ground a little.
Yep. 48 inches inside. Unbelievable bull, one of the second best bull ever to come out of this unit.
Congratulations to Ron and all who helped him. What an awesome bull. A summer and fall of scouting has paid off and created memories that will last forever for all those who took part in finding and harvesting a beautiful one-of-a-kind bull.
Once in a lifetime bull right here.
What do you think? Tell us about it.
Well, we saw some great bulls early in the year, and it's they say you can't shoot a big one if you shoot a smaller one, and that proved true. And this is absolutely once in a lifetime chance to shoot a bull like this. And he's an old bull, he's a mature bull, and it was his time has come. And I really want to thank Doyle and Greg and Kaylin and all the people that made this possible. It's a dream come true for me to shoot a bull like this.
Awesome! Congratulations!
Yep. Thank you very much.
Not wrong.
Thank you.
Watch for our latest video and check out our website.